Cyrus Jones, 1810 to 1913. Made his great-grandchildren believe you could live to 103. 103 is forever when you're just a little kid. So Cyrus Jones, live forever.
Listen to the following conversation and be prepared to answer questions at the end. Good luck.
John, what do you think about the case of the 111-year-old pensioner who turned out to have been dead for about 30 years?
It's no surprise. When you keep the records on paper in City Hall or the ward office and depend on volunteers to look for these people while being careful not to break the privacy laws, you're going to have problems keeping track of people, especially elderly people.
Yes, and the efforts to move records of the population to a centralized computer have been resisted by unions representing City Hall and ward office workers. Maybe we should put GPS trackers on the centenarians, but no, that would be against the privacy laws too.
I'm sure it would be, but we don't want to be paying pensions to dead people either. Improvements are needed to prevent that, and who knows, maybe Japan's claim to have over 41,000 centenarians is overstated, and the life expectancy rates are skewed a little too high.
I doubt that the numbers are that far off, but we can't expect dead centenarians to send the government death certificates either. John, do you want me to keep tabs on you as you near the century mark?
Ha ha, I'm not that old, and you're no spring chicken yourself, Al.
Is there such a thing as a half-centenarian?
Of course.
Listen to the following questions and answer choices. Choose the most appropriate answer choice and write it down. Then check www.smithweb.co.jp/soapbox or the TOEIC link on the main page for the correct answers. Good luck.
Question 1. What did Al ask John? A. What he thought about paying pensions to 111-year-old dead people. B. How soon he would be 111 years old. C. How long the 111-year-old pensioner had been missing. D. What did the 111-year-old pensioner turn out to be?
Question 2. What was John's response to this question? A. He was surprised that they were having so much trouble. B. He was not surprised given the use of paper records and volunteers to look for the centenarians while abiding by the strict privacy laws. C. He was surprised that a country as advanced as Japan could not keep track of its elderly citizens. D. He suggested that families of centenarians should be responsible to provide annual proof that an elderly family member is still alive, such as a doctor's certificate.
Question 3. Why did Al say that moving records of the population to a centralized computer has not been achieved? A. Because there are no centralized computers big enough to store all the personal data. B. Because it is against the privacy laws. C. Because such efforts have been resisted by unions representing City Hall and ward office workers. D. Because it is necessary to keep the paper supply companies in business.
Question 4. How did Al react to John's comment that Japan's claim to have over 41,000 centenarians might be overstated and the life expectancy rates skewed a little too high? A. Al said that he doubted that the numbers could be so far off. B. Al agreed with John. C. Al said that John could check the numbers in his spare time. D. Al said that dead centenarians should be required to send in death certificates.
Curtis Jones, 1810 to 1913, made his great-grandchildren believe you could live to 103. 103 is forever when you're just a little kid. So Cyrus Jones lived forever.
If you've been thinking about whether you should start to study English and actually acquire the ability to use it for real purpose, don't put it off any longer. Give us a call at 0120-222-248 and schedule a trial lesson at a Smith School of English near you. The time to start is now.